The invitation is my great honor to be here. Today I will talk about some mathematical results for non-convex space retrieval. So first I will reveal some mathematical results in convex retrieval. So such as results for the sampling rate for under Gaussian model and the sampling rate for coded diffraction patterns model. I will also reveal some results for noisy phase retrieval and sparse phase retrieval. And in the next, I will introduce our non-convex phase retrieval method, which is gradient-determined Wirtinger flow. So this is a collaborative research by my PhD advisor, Daniel Candice, and Mark Sotano Kohan. Basically, figures introduced in my talk are made by Mahdi Sultano Kotabi. I'll also introduce some recent results. We modify this grid. The grid showed it to the society. And using this, we can spark something. Sometimes reduce the sampling rate. So this is a collaborative research with Tony Kai and Zhong Ming. So first, let's phase retrieval. We want to recover an n-dimensional complex signal by element-wise magnitudes measurements ax squared. So here, obviously, we have an identifiability issue. If we change global phase signal, then the result, the quadratic measurements will be the same. So for the best, we can only for the signal to the whole system is determined by the sensing matrix A. Sensing matrix A is a n by n matrix. One is called in this model, consists of ID standard complex variables. So although this model is not really practical, but it is in term for theory. We also discussed another mathematical model, which is called coded diffraction patterns model. And this model matrix A is basically determined by the Fourier transform and some random masks. We will introduce the mathematical model later. The motivation for this coded diffraction patterns is from X-ray crystal. So suppose we have a beam of X-rays, and suppose they are diffracted by atomic structure. And the diffracted signals are modulated by some random masks. And the modulated signals are measured on the far end by their magnitudes. So this models the coded diffraction patterns. OK, so a key observation is made by Chai, Moscoso, and Papanicolo in 2000. So this observation is, although we have nonlinear measurements, or measurements, however, if we consider the self-outer product x times adjoint, then the quadratic measurements B are actually the linear measurements of this rank one positive semidefinite matrix. So the question is to recover a rank one matrix from its linear measurement. Then we can come to the literature of matrix optimization. So there are two famous papers. One is by Recht, Faisal, and Perillo in 2007 for matrix sensing. Another paper is by Candice in 2008. Here we can recover the low rank matrix by minimizing the nuclear norm subject to the linear relationship. Okay, so and for the retrieval, we know that this matrix is also positive. So we can just add this property as a constraint into the convex optimization. The norm of so paper by Candice Elders, they proposed this optimization framework and more important interesting theoretical result under the Gaussian model. So said that as long as the number of measurements is greater than m sub n up to some constant, then with high probability this complex can recover the low rank matrix. So technically speaking, there are some novelty in this paper. For example, it's based on the for the only one step Gaussian scheme and also establish local L1 RP. Based on the same modify the let's see the coded diffraction patterns model. So the number of measurements here, this so the mask and the difference represents the sensing on the okay, so how to what kind of random so we call this admissible modulations. We assume this entries of D are I random variables inequalities this three equality constraints. These three the constraints are satisfied automatically by standard complex Gaussian variables. But however, standard complex Gaussian variables are not bounded, or almost surely is bounded by growing log n, but we can random variables satisfying strings by using some discrete variable. So basically use discrete random variables to meet the continuous standard Gaussian random variables. So under this coded depression patterns model with admissible modulations, we prove that as long as we have more than log 4n random masks, this PhaseLift convex optimization method can recover the signal with high probability. So later this result by Rosemary in 2014 removing some. Okay, let's see the so the goal is scale simulations. We want to know empirically how many masks are enough for PhaseLift to recover the low rank matrix exactly. So we consider binary masks, which are not really admissible. Binary masks, which are admissible. Gaussian model. So Gaussian model. L is M over N. So for different kinds of signals, see that we signal exactly by using PhaseLift. Some observation is the empirical behavior of to of Gaussian measure. For inadmissible random masks, such as binary masks, the behavior is a little bit worse. Okay, so for noisy phase retrieval, suppose some additive noise to the element-wise magnitude measurements. here is the noise is noise. And we propose to minimize the airway norm of the residual subject to the positive semi-definite strait. Our result is as long as number of measurement is greater than a constant times n, we can have an upper bound for the rank one matrix recovery. So because here there's no condition on the noise, so this upper bound is very easily to show, we can easily show that this upper bound is tight. But actually, even if suppose someone is stochastic, i.e. stochastic Gaussian variable, as long as m is linear with n, this bound is also tight in terms of constant. However, if m is much larger than n, maybe we need to minimize the L2 norm of the residual to get an optimal convergence rate for the estimation. So what happens if the signal is sparse or if the signal is known to be sparse under some linear transformation? So here we just assume the linear transformation. We add another penalization, which is the entry-wise L1 of the matrix. If we can as long as the number of measurement is greater than k squared, with high probability that facelift can recover the signal exactly. Notice that it's different from greater than k, right? So, for convex, we need n is greater than k squared. And we have a positive result. So with hyper with respect to the random sensing matrix k, can recover the signal exactly, and this will imply that the greater than k squared.
So here you find over a one matrix. At the same time, you're assuming that it's a sparse.
Yes. Yeah, if lambda equals zero, actually it doesn't work. The reason is it's not like RP matrix. So that's the reason. You can view it as weighted L1 because we just like the diagonal entries of X, right? So here you can view it as a weighted L1 for the X and for the diagonal. This is just L1 minimization.
Well, it certainly does not, but if you only use two ways, more measurements in that. So you need to ask about the, that's for sure. But it could be that you can drop the trace condition.
Okay, and if you, you're screwed.
Yeah, for the, so there's a cost lambda, it depends on K, so it's not a, numerically,
not so much. Because numerically, essentially, you don't need the trace, really. It's the risk to even the air numerically, but then
numerically. Okay. So, the problem of this. computational cost, the other is the cost in terms of time. So in terms of computation, because we are working on the some definite program, and iterative full SVD, and the large system, another reason is for the memory. So originally for the face problem, actually, so only need memory, we only for the memory cost is just the n. We do not the n square memory, and l memory random diagonal matrices, right? Because the matrix is not however, by the lifting IV, we to update the estimation for x is n square memory problem for the memory, and we want to propose a new method to be as reliable as PhaseLift. Secondly, we hope this method is computationally convex. And second, we hope it is more efficient in terms of memory. So these are two things using the fitting. So the objective function is the least square function. And because we have quadratic measurement, function is actually a force of to z and z bar. Okay. Is greater than n, then all the global minimizers of first order polynomial, the signal circle is determined by the signal up to some global phase. Have uniqueness of phase retrieval, but because we have random variables or random sensing matrix. In 2011. For fixed x, actually we only need m to be to recover this. Okay, so we have some advantage of this framework. There is no constraint, and also it is smooth, which means its gradient is easily computed. However, there is a problem because it's first order polynomial, so it is not. Then whether we have local convexity. Small neighborhood for signals such complex session. So the answer is we can prove it for any small neighborhood of the signals. Find some point such that is small is negative. The reason actually can be seen clearly here. So this signal circle, if the point is in this on this side, it like a saddle. So why the negative smallest eigenvalue of the Hessian can be negative no matter how this point is close to the. So I mentioned. My friend, who is a mathematician before, and he told me that this is too obvious by his intuition for this. What's the point? quadratic measurements effectively, and it is very accurate. Okay, and then we construct the matrix W by using quadratic measurements sensing matrix. Because the sensing matrix, the matrix is the matrix. The leading eigenvector associated with the leading eigenvalue. Initialization is makes sense. So we consider this the expectation of this random matrix, which is and that means true signal is the lead of its expectation because its leading eigenvector is leading and associated eigenvector is x. And as long as the number of measurements is large enough, we can show that that concentrated around its expectation. So that's the reason why this initialization makes sense. Actually, we can prove that as long as m is greater than m log, the distance between the initialization and the circle is less than 1/10. So spectral initialization for low-rank recovery is first introduced by Montanari and Ho, and also in phase retrieval is proposed by Nitrapli, Zhen, and Sangavi. I also heard this result in the talk. After the initialization, we for the function gradient descent. So because the objective function is for the polynomial is the third order. And it can be conveniently so some pretty the name working well because that the function as a function with real variables, just take the partial but what still is somehow essential. For example, if we want to calculate the gradient back to the real part and the imaginary part, the expression is complicated and if we want to compare the real part and the imaginary part. Take the part the imaginary. So that's why the is actually. And then our goal is working flow can converge to the signal circle with the convergence rate. There's a concept called contractive neighborhood. So this as long as the initialization lies in this contractive neighborhood, this contractive neighborhood, and the distance from the updates to the signal circle initiation. And then for phase retrieval, you find it somehow close to the signal circle. And then there are two important directions. This this property can be inequality. So, well, this is between the inequality of the inequality. As long as this inequality holds for any point in this neighborhood, we can call this neighborhood, contracting neighborhood. As long as one this bound is, so we can hope that a smaller convergence. The contracting neighborhood is established as the parameter beta. So beta are larger than is close to, it means the convergence rate. Number of iterations, so still as long as alpha and beta are larger, it takes more iterations. Okay, let's write this flow. The first question is how many samples rate to that is we need n times log n number of samples to establish a reasonably large contractive. The second question is what's the radius of this contractive neighborhood? Whether is it convergence rate, or how fast the or what's the number of to for the convergence? It's on the order of n. Okay, empirical. We see enter the model or enter the coded model. Basically, we need five for working flow to mask for the working flow to recover the signal efficiently. Okay. Fraction patterns model with admissible with admissible random masks. Actually, we can still result as long as the number of measurement number of masks is greater than log n. So actually, this calls truncated workflow. So the same idea is, for example, for the convex method, non-convex method. By using the idea, we can remove it. But here, in the paper, we for initialization. Okay. Yeah, but I mean, just for, because for this result, we need a spectral initialization, right? I think this truncated workflow, Immanuel Kant, the key point is not a truncated gradient descent, but actually the essential point is the truncated. The size of is very steep. We can recover the first you mentioned our recent result in noise retrieval. So here we assume we have some additive noise. For analytical convenience, we assume A is causing its real value. We also assume X is real. Assume they are independent. And they are they have sub. And there's a, for example, sub-exponential. For X, we assume X is on its own. And there's some notation. The support of X is denoted as X, and the sparsity of X is denoted. So why it is helpful if we know the signal is basically there are two reasons. First, we use the sparse prior to denoise. Second, maybe we use function to reduce the required number of samples. Go. And the answer is yes or no. Okay, so how to achieve these goals? We need to modify the standard work. So basically, we need to parse a position, and we hope the sequence of animations are smart. So do some thresholding somewhere. OK, let's see how to modify the spectral initialization. We do some thresholding. If the diagonal entries are larger than some threshold, then we select this variable. Because this means that the corresponding variable contributes to the depth measurement. And then by using the diagonal thresholding, we can have a small random random matrix, and we calculate its leading eigenvector initialization. So we can put that as it's consistent. Okay. Is how to modify the gradient descent method. Okay, the problem is even if you assume xt is good, is contained in the true support, but the gradient descent support can be optimal, right? You need to do some thresholding, and ideally. To this part for us to establish the linear convergence. So we establish a new contractive neighborhood, the subspace. Question is, if you not know S, it's due to use the idea of special word. Software. The key of this new method to choose, we propose to choose this threshold adaptively. Notice that if you use the idea such as lasso, then you cannot have an adaptive threshold, right? The threshold will be we use an adaptive threshold bank. There are two principles to choose this. First, such the update is and second is the threshold should be small enough such that to the oracle projection. Okay, so suppose x hat t is on s, then basically we need to consider the infinity norm of the off complement. So ideally, we just want to choose what's the upper bound, what's the infinity norm of this vector. Here we use a curie. Is statistically independent to A as complement, then we can create a very upper bound for the infinity of this vector. So we use it as the threshold, as the adaptive threshold, because this threshold depends on the current estimation. A result is by choosing the parameters correctly, and if the next is greater than the error. And the x first term is statistical error. We want to mention that this statistical max the lower bound established using some brute force method. And also, we have a heuristic. We calculate this adaptive threshold by using the assumption that xt is independent to A as complement. But this assumption doesn't hold. This assumption. So we can understand it like that as almost. So in the community, there are some numerical results. Here, this is standard, not those threshold, and the relative error. But by using some coding, by using this set method, we can reduce the estimation. Empirically, we can use empirically the relative error while the working flow is higher. So actually this method really utilizes the sparse assumption, because by using this sparse assumption we can reduce the error. There's some related most alternating method to phase retrieval, and they have some theoretical results. Our improvement, the most important improvement of our method is to not use the heuristic argument of resampling. And in my opinion, a very important contribution in our method, we in the concept of contraction. So notice that principally, contractive neighborhood means as long as the initialization lies in this contractive neighborhood, then it will not get out of the contractive neighborhood. At the same time, it will converge to the true signal. The relationship between the sample size and the existence of So there is some following work. This analytical framework for phase retrieval to more general. Consider one example. This paper is to use a similar solve matrix expression problem and the law. And they have a, they have basically they use the same framework, but the definition of contractive neighborhood is more complicated. I will not explain this of the this. For the row round the default our initialization in the contracting neighborhood, it will get out of the neighborhood conversion. Okay, that's it. Okay. Yeah, it's open. So I have some friends who are interested in whether this K square is a fundamental lower bound for all computationally feasible methods. So you know, here the key point is we assume the sensing matrix is random, is totally random, like CDP or Gaussian model. So basically, it means this sensing matrix is structureless. So for structureless sensing matrix, work for this retrieval is very similar to the, just in people's minds, it's very similar to the conditional bound for plenty click and sparse PCA. But you know, for sparse PCA, people have a reduction argument to the plenty click. But here, it's still open. People, there's no any interesting argument to show that there's a computational lower bound for sparse phase retrieval by Hausdorff. But our work is this is a fundamental lower bound for a specific type of convex phase.